The sense of taste, or your ability to taste things, is relayed by three different cranial nerves because they cover different areas of the tongue and of the upper part of the larynx or pharynx. So the first one is the facial nerve, and we'll talk a lot more about the facial nerve when we talk about the cranial nerves that innervate the face. The glossopharyngeal nerve, we'll talk a lot more about that when we talk about the larynx and pharynx, and the vagus nerve, which we'll talk a lot about when we talk about parasympathetics. So just in general, we divide the tongue into a couple of regions that are based on its development from the embryo. So we talk about the body of the tongue of here, and we talk about the root. The root and the body of the tongue are based on this line here called the sulcus. So this part is the pre-sulcal part of the tongue. And back here behind it is the post-sulcal, it's kind of a mouthful, part of the tongue. So pre and post have different innervations with regard to taste and with regard to general sensation. In the next slide, I just want to talk about the fact, some of the pathways related to taste. So when we talked about general sensation in the rest of the body, so in our spinal nerves and our segmental nerves, we talked about the dorsal root ganglia being the primary sensory neurons for all of the sensations that you feel with regard to gross touch and fine touch, pain and temperature. So for the special senses, there are also ganglia involved. For the retina, the ganglion cells of the retina that project out that we talked about, that's basically the ganglion, and it's part of the retina itself. When it comes to the special senses of taste, what we're talking about are neurons that live in three different ganglia that are associated with the three nerves that carry this modality. With the seventh cranial nerve, it's called the geniculate ganglion. And it's called the geniculate ganglion because it's at the bend or genu of the seventh cranial nerve. As it goes through the head, it has this very circuitous course. And there's a particular area where it makes a very sharp bend. They call it the genu, so that's the geniculate ganglia. For 9 and 10, they both have sensory ganglia associated with them. They both have a superior and an inferior ganglia that are associated with both of these nerves. And the fibers that are related to taste, their cell bodies live in the inferior ganglion of both nerves. So, taste receptors, my thing's on, taste receptors out here in the tongue, in both the pre and the post-sulcal areas. Their cell bodies are in one of these ganglia, and then they project via that cranial nerve back to the brainstem. And there are specific areas in the brainstem where these guys are going to synapse, and that's not really that important for you right now. And again, the information then goes from the brainstem to the cortex, and then up to, or I'm sorry, it goes from the brainstem to the thalamus and then to the cortex. So specific areas of the thalamus and then to areas of the cortex, the insular cortex. And this kind of makes sense. When we talked about the insula, we talked about it being a relay for visceral pain and other sorts of pain. So having taste and a little bit of olfaction is going to project here too, because you know how closely linked olfactory sensations and taste sensations are. Because when you have a bad cold and your nose is stuffed up, things just don't taste the same. It's because both of those sensory modalities are going to insular cortex. Insular cortex also, again, is getting visceral sensations, and so that helps put together things that look, that things that smell bad and taste bad might make you pukey. And so all of that kind of information gets stored, and it helps you avoid anything in the future that maybe upset your stomach. It helps coordinate all that information together for you. So, taste receptors, cell bodies in the geniculate ganglion or the inferior ganglia of the cranial nerves 9 and 10, relays in the brainstem to the thalamus and then up to insular cortex for perception. In the last segment of this lecture, we're going to talk about your sense of balance and your sense of hearing.